Hey, what's going on, Wildlife X team? This is Michael here, and what is the animal that is most likely to bite you in the world? Take your guess right now. Is it a snake? Is it a bear? Is it a spider? Is it a raccoon? Take your guess right now and write it down, because I guarantee you the animal which is most likely to bite us or you is actually going to surprise you. The answer to this is a squirrel. Now, this comes as a surprise to a lot of people, because even though squirrels are the most common rodent pests in neighborhoods, they usually avoid people's homes, direct conflicts are rare, and they're just in every single American park, and they don't come up to us, they stay away from us, and you know, they just don't do anything. So why are these the animals which are most likely to bite people? Well, the answer to this is because they're incredibly fast and they're incredibly common. So even though squirrels are maybe less frequently biting us than raccoons or another wildlife animal, simply because there are so many more squirrels than other wildlife animals, that is why they are the most likely animal to bite us. Another big problem which has been increasing the frequency of squirrel bites is because residents as well as people in parks have been feeding squirrels, and these animals naturally shy away from humans. However, when you're giving them food, they're getting more comfortable with us, so they feel like they can bite us, they feel like they can go through to us, and this is pretty dangerous because these rodents have jaws that are strong enough to chew through wood. So wounds can be very deep. If you get bit by a squirrel and it's untreated, it could become infected as well as spread disease. Squirrels are usually not the most likely to bite. However, like we said, they're the most common. And in fact, we did an interview with many of the Wildlife X Team franchisee owners where we were talking to them, what are the most likely animals to bite? And we initially thought that it would be a raccoon or another animal or something like that. Snakes were actually a close second, so snakes are the second most likely to bite people for obvious reason. However, the number one animal most likely to bite people is squirrel, and that's because they're simply also extremely fast. Squirrels can run at a speed of at least 20 miles per hour or 32 kilometers per hour. There are even some species of squirrels that are quite literally able to fly. So these creatures are fast, they have epic reaction speeds, so if you're trying to capture them or do something, they can just snap by and bite you really, really quick. Another problem with these creatures is because their jaws are so strong, again, strong enough to chew through wood, even if you have protective gear such as gloves, which are adequate for wildlife removal, they're often able to cause bruising as well as pain through the very, very thick gloves. And this is just because they are so strong. One problem with squirrels also is wildlife infestation. Again, these aren't the most likely animals to infest people's homes. However, when they do infest your attic or get in between your walls or do something like that, these creatures get frightened very, very easy. Again, we can see in the park that if you try to go up to them, they pretty much run away and they stay away from us. However, if you find them in your attic or in between the walls or somewhere in a closed area, they get extremely defensive and they don't want to stay anywhere near you, so they will bite. So this is one of the biggest problems, and when they do get up in an attic or something like that, this is when people are most likely to get bit. So if you do have a squirrel or you see a squirrel, don't feed it and don't go near it, because these creatures are snappy, they are fast, and they will bite you before you even know it. If you do get bit by a squirrel though, make sure you go see a doctor immediately. It's unlikely that there are rabies in squirrels. In fact, it's very rare. However, it's not impossible. And if you do get bit by a creature which has rabies, there are usually no symptoms for some time. However, then all the symptoms just come. And when symptoms start coming, it usually means it's too late and then you unfortunately die. There are other diseases which can be spread by squirrels, and the bite itself can get infected. So again, if you are bit by a squirrel or any wildlife creature for that matter, make sure you get it treated by a proper doctor so that way you don't get infected and you stay healthy and safe. So we hope you enjoyed this quick little tidbit of content. Again, we have interviewed almost all of the Wildlife X Team franchisee owners, and the ones that are most likely to get bit have always been squirrels, with snakes coming at a close second. Other wildlife animals such as possums or raccoons, they are very likely to bite people, and in fact the frequency at which they would attempt to bite people is higher. However, because those creatures are less common and they're not as fast and we're more prepared for them, it usually tends not to happen as much as squirrels. So if you do see a squirrel again, avoid it, as it is extremely snappy and fast and very likely to bite you. Thank you for listening to this. We hope you enjoyed. Let us know what you think, and we'll see you later. Bye.
They're out there looking for a home, and they found one. Yours. They want that cozy place in your attic or under your foundation. Give them enough time, and you'll be paying big bucks to fix their damage. Wildlife X Team specializes in removal and prevention of wildlife infestation, responsibly and professionally. Wildlife X Team has earned the top-rated award from Home Advisors because they're experts at what they do. Just one call, and they're gone. 855-WILDLIFE or wildlifexteam.com.